Most of the time when a major project came along, we were told what the goal was, the timing, what we had to do, and just to get the job done. Today, we get up any time of the night or any time of the morning, flip the switch, and the lights are on. When it comes to the new projects, such as the 765 kV system, you don't know it's achievable. We will try. So all the department heads got together and people, and we just sat around the table and said, okay, we have our goals. And once we agreed to it, we all knew that was binding. And sometimes you had a hiccup and you had to stop and say, guys, we have to slow this thing down. And there were hundreds of projects going on. Some small, it took months. Some like the 765 took years. Drudgery. This was a fun place to work. And the day you're going to finally pull that switch and see that generator turn over and it's generating kilowatt hours, it's magnanimous. You stand there and look back at 4 years and I contributed to this. And all of us had that same feeling. George Tidd was the chairman of AG&E at the time. So his vision was that we had another town over here with a little generator. And if we make that generator bigger in the future, and this one bigger, then if this plant goes down, we still have power coming from this plant over here. And that was the start of the transmission and the grid as they know it today. We owned Atlantic City Electric, we owned Scranton, and so forth back in those days, and they gradually began to tie all of these things together. And it's constantly, it's 24/7, there are people watching this. We solved many, many of the problems in the electric industry. We know them as the solvers. We did it, we solved it, you guys can use that technology. The utility industry grew as a result of the innovations of AEP and other people. At home, I got many, many phone calls, 2, 3, 4 o'clock in the morning. How are you feeling? I said, great, what happened? Then you go to work early. So it was a cooperative effort. And the company was always interested in developing the people to be leaders, to be managers, and also to be better engineers. And that was part of the legacy of AEP. And I think if the company keeps on that way, they'll be fine into the future, I'm sure.
Electricity is an interesting product. It needs to be available 7 days a week, 365 days out of the year. It's the only commodity that really needs to be provided on demand.
AEP has a huge commitment to its customers in providing reliable electric service, and we see every day that our needs are growing and changing.
This is a time like no other in my career. A lot has changed in our industry over the last decade plus, and that has put a lot of new opportunities and challenges for transmission owners in the United States.
The AEP transmission system essentially aggregates generation located all across the country, whether it be fueled by nuclear, coal, gas, wind, or solar.
We face much greater challenges than we ever have. We're doing more transmission than ever because the country needs more transmission. The kind of sources of energy have changed, and the transmission system is the transportation system for power from its source to where the loads are.
AEP has always relied on the innovation of its employees to make a difference, both to its customers as well as the technology that it provides. AEP is well positioned to grow, not only within its boundaries, but also outside of its traditional service territories. With that growth will be opportunities for engineers, project managers, folks with a financial background. I'm excited about the changes. I'm excited and thrilled to have a strong group of employees who are dedicated to doing what they need to do to make sure that AEP is going to be relevant in the transmission space in the future. AEP has always relied on the innovation of its employees to make a difference, both to its customers as well as the technology that it provides.
I probably can't think of a time that's been more exciting than the current time, and that's in part because we face much greater challenges than we ever have, and we're doing more transmission than ever because the country needs more transmission.
I am confident in our employees and their ability to make that happen, and I'm excited about what's in store for the future and the technology enhancements that we can bring to consumers.